All right, looks like we're live. For a second there, it was having trouble connecting to the internet, but it looks like I am on. So, good morning. It's Wednesday and it's March 25th. And it's a absolutely beautiful morning out there this morning. It feels like spring, and then as I walk across to the church, the birds are singing, and it's really one of those mornings that I can definitely remember mornings exactly like this, being out on a horseback, out amongst the cows, getting ready to calve. And so these kind of mornings always bring back wonderful memories for me. So I love days like this. The only problem with days like this is it's spring and my sinuses don't love spring. So bear with me as my sinuses give me a little bit of grief today. But that's part of spring. I do love spring, but I wish my sinuses loved it. Today we're going to be looking at Psalm 13. So if you want to grab your Bible and take a look at Psalm 13 before we jump into the devotional, I do want to share with you some positive information. I read this morning that the Ford Motor Company is going to or is apparently ramping up to build some rest and some respirators, some I can't ventilators, that's the word I wanted, ventilators and respirators, as well as face shields and face masks for the medical community. And so that's a wonderful blessing. Also, I saw that the My Pillow company is now making face masks. So plus there's tons of people out there. My cousin Mike is one, and some others that I see online that are making face masks for the medical community. There are some plans apparently online somewhere that show how to make them with filters in them. And it's important that you have the filters in them, because otherwise you just will put a kerchief around your face, look like the old cowboys from the westerns. And that's somewhat effective, but it's not for the medical community by any stretch. So we do have those good news. There's a good news. I keep seeing reports that the hydrochloroquine is helping different people around the country. I saw something out of Kansas and some other places where there's some good news of doctors having great success with that medication. And so there's some really bright, shining stars out there. So we don't want to get depressed by any stretch. And also, I want to let you to know today, I we don't care. We're Protestants, but we don't care. Prayer is good. Where the Pope has asked for people today, the 25th, and I'm not sure if that's today, Rome time or our own time, but I'd say let's just do it at our time. The Pope has asked for people to pray at noon today, for the world and for healing from this virus, and for everyone that's suffering with it. So remember that at noon today to try to sit down and spend just a few minutes in prayer for the world and for your family, and remember to include in that prayer the praise for God, that He has blessed us with such an amazing world, and that we are coming up on Easter, and we don't want to forget that grace and salvation that comes with the Easter message. So we want to remember that. So there are some really wonderful, bright things out there, in contrast to the numbers that you might see on some of the counters. We want to be careful, and I'm as guilty, and don't ask my wife that, but she'll tell you I'm just as guilty as any at getting fixated on numbers, because I am some reasonably analytical kind of a person, and I like to analyze things, so I can get caught up in the numbers, and we have to remember that. But the other bright thing that's out there this morning that I almost forgot to share with you, Oxford University, wonderful, prestigious university. Apparently, researchers there have released a report today, and it's on my Facebook page. If you're friends with me, you can go look at my Facebook page, and you'll see the report, mention of the report out of Oxford. And the Oxford researchers are thinking that this virus has been around longer than we thought, and that there are already millions of people in the world that have already come down with it and recovered. And so that kind of ties in with some of Kylie Hildreth has kind of implied that when we've talked to her, and I've talked to some other people that kind of thought, my sister-in-law, she seemed to think that as well. And there's a lot of people thinking that it's been around longer than we thought, and that people have caught it and gotten over it and just thought they had a really bad flu. So there is that hope that is true, because if that's the case, that there's already millions of people have caught in it and gotten over and are immune to it, that'll definitely shorten this chaos that we find ourselves in. So we pray for that, and that's a good thing to lift up in prayer at noon when you pray. But don't forget to do that at noon today. Sit down for a second or two, or a minute or two. I shouldn't say second. Take longer than that, for a few minutes, and lift up praise and petition to God about this. So today we are in Psalm 13. This is another Psalm of David, and of course David had a very tumultuous life. He endured so much. We look at him as the pinnacle of God's kings on earth. But David didn't have an easy life, and we remember that. So we're looking at Psalm 13, and I'm going to be reading today from the Holman Christian Standard Bible. It's probably not one that too many people have on their shelf, and I'm going to read from the computer screen today, because my copy of the Holman Christian Standard Bible, the print is about this big, itty bitty, teeny weeny, and I'm not going to sit there and try to read it out loud. I might read it to myself from that Bible, but my old eyes don't like that little teeny itty bitty rice grain size print. So, Psalm 13. Lord, how long will you forget me? Forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long will I store up anxious concerns within me, agony in my mind every day? How long will my enemies dominate me? Consider me and answer, Lord, my God. Restore brightness to my eyes, otherwise I will sleep in death. My enemy will say I have triumphed over him, and my foes will rejoice because I am shaken. But I have trusted in your faithful love. My heart will rejoice in your deliverance. I will sing to the Lord because he has treated me generously. And truly, God has treated you generously today. But as we go through this time, and especially those that are doing their absolute best to shutter in place and stay in one spot. God bless my daughter Madeline is doing a wonderful job of staying indoors, it sounds like, when I talk to her. At least that's what she's telling her father. I thank her for that, and so is our son. So for those people, though, we can start to feel like everything is, oh, what do I want to say? But we can fixate on the bad news. That's why I tried to share with you right out of the gate today, good news. Because there's a lot of good news out there. There's a lot of progress being made. And this isolating is difficult because we are such, as I've said before, we are such social creatures, and we get anxious and we get worried. That's because we're human. We worry, and we fixate on things, and we create so many things in our mind, you know. And I forget who it said it. It might have been Mark Twain that said, "In my life, I've had 99 worries, and one of them actually came to pass." And that's very true for us. And I think I paraphrased that a little bit. I don't think I got that quote exactly right because it just popped into my head. But it's true. So much of what we worry about doesn't really ever come to pass. And we may, at the end of this thing, kind of think, well, what was the big worry about if it doesn't turn out as bad as what we have said or what they have projected? But we do want to remember that that's the point. The reason that we're doing this stay at home and social distancing is that it won't get as bad as the projections were telling us they would. So there's a point to all this. And remember that, and take solace, take pride, take grace in the fact that you are doing what you can to help your brother and sister. And there's a meme online that I shared this morning that said, "Remember," just talking to the young people, "remember that if the roles were reversed and this disease was affecting the young, that your parents and grandparents would do whatever they had to do to help you." So if that means that we ourselves or with just our husbands and wives and kids, make that into a positive thing. Look for the joy in that. Get out the coloring books. Color with the kids, get out some whatever kind of craft things, some glue and some paper. There's all kinds of fun things that you can do with the kids, and the kids looking back at this, and it could end up being the happiest memory of your children when they get old, or your grandchildren if you're lucky enough to have the grandchildren with you. Don't always look for the cloud in this. We tend to do that. Look outside today. It's an absolutely beautiful day, like I said earlier. And it's the birds are singing, and there's new life out there. And again, it's the time of year that I love because it always brings back all those memories of calving season. And I love those memories. And those are all memories of new life. But even amongst that new life of calving, you have some crisis and some hardship. And I've told stories before about losing calves and losing cows and things like that, and the lessons you learn from that. Life isn't easy, but it's a beautiful thing. So praise be to God, and thank Him for all of that. In the end of the psalm, David says, "But I've trusted in your faithful love. My heart will rejoice in your deliverance. God will deliver you. God does love you." And he says, "I will sing to the Lord because he has treated me generously." God has treated you absolutely generously. The last thing I'll share with you is remember these words that we find in the 49th chapter of Isaiah. And this is talking about God's love for us. And it's comparing God's love to a mother's. And he's the "Can a mother forget the baby at her breast and have no compassion on the child she has born?" And truly, there is nothing like a mother's love. Though we usually talk about God in a patriarchal of a fatherly role, God doesn't have a gender. Remember that. And God's love for us is both mother father type love. He loves us as deeply as a mother loves her newborn child. And at the end of that sentence, the prophet says, "I will not forget you." And that's God speaking to you. God will not forget you. He never has. He never will. Remember, as you go forth from here, to be a blessing to someone today. Let's end today in a quick prayer, shall we? So we'll take off our hat for just a moment. You can look at my shiny head. I should have powdered it. But let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the beautiful spring morning that you've blessed us with and fill our heart with. Oh, that there is hope, there is glory, that there is some coming soon from your hand, from whatever this is that is plaguing us, dear Lord, whether it be the virus or whether it be our own plaguing us today. We know that you will deliver us because we know you love us just as much as a mother loves her newborn child. And Lord, that is the beauty of your relationship to us. Let us reach out to you and extend your blessing to others. We pray this in your glory. Amen. You all have a wonderful day. And as I said earlier, be a blessing to someone today. Talk to you tomorrow. Bye-bye.